ज्ञान यस Wheat futures. No, this was not the prediction. I will tell you, this was not the prediction. Anyway.
So, yeah, we are keen to learn on that. But this is what my broad understanding of the ETF is.
Okay. And someone from there. Yeah, please. Gan? Okay. Okay. What do you know about Gan? WD Gan as a person?
As a person, he is the one known as a best trader. Almost he plays around 400 trades. Out of that, 82% of his trade turn in his favor.
Done. Now, as you said, Gan fan or trend lines, 45 degree. You use a software. Okay. Great. Okay. So here I take it forward. I will do injustice if I don't talk about the person, because until and unless you know a person, I think it is not correct to follow that person. First, you must understand who the person was, what was his pedigree. Now, W.D. Gann was born in 1878. Which is the oldest trader you are aware, successful trader, the oldest name probably? He was contemporary. He was born in 1877 and Gann was born in 1878. So basically birth date difference is 6 months. Did J.C. Livermore ever write a book? He wrote two books. Which one? No. Renaissance of a Stock Market Operator was written in, he never wrote it. It was written by someone else. Jesse Livermore only wrote one book, if I am correct, How to Trade Stocks, that he wrote in 1940. W.D. Gann wrote his first book 1923. So, why I am trying to impress this, for a simple reason, in the whatever history we know, Gann was the first successful trader, best trader of his times. Do you know who was one of the famous names who traded before Gann? You'll be surprised, I think. Everyone will be surprised. No, it was Isaac Newton. He lost heavily because he thought the markets will also follow law of gravity, which never did. So, coming back to W.D. Gann, so this is the one person who is the oldest in times, the first person to write books about his successful trading. His first book was written in 1923. So, none of the traders have ever written before that. I'm trying to prove a point. That is why I'm going in a circle. So, 1923 was the first book. He has been trading since the age of 28 basically. So 1908 he started trading, 1906 he started trading, 1909 he became super famous. We will come to that point, how he became famous in 1909. But this is the reason I take Gyan writings as Bhagavad Gita, Bible, Quran for a trader. And I request, whether you follow Gyan, you don't follow Gyan, the first book of Gyan, that is Truth of the Stock Tape, please get that book. Don't read it. Please study it. Reading will take you 2 hours, but please study it at least 10 times. You will find probably that he has written about you. First person to write about trading psychology from A to Z. I have been in markets for the last 28 years. There's one point only I will touch, which is, I have for the last 5-7 years, I have been listening about paper trading. After post quants and these algos came, I have started coming across this term called paper trading. In his first book, 1923 written, he's written 3 chapters on paper trading. What is happening is, we are trying to find pearls here and there, as probably we are from multiple religions, but I don't think that any one of you have read ever Bhagavad Gita, Rig Ved, Upanishad, Puran, Kiran, Bible. I have done. Because that is the basis. The problem is, we don't go to the basis. We try to find a godman, a sadguru or someone who will read from there bits and pieces and put you your interpretation. The interpretation will be filtered to his advantage. Please go to this, go through his book called The Truth of the Stock Tape, written in 1923. It was the first book, and you will understand how well it is written, and every bit of you as a trader is covered there. Every bit of you as a trader is covered there. You will probably feel that it is written about you. All the mistakes probably you have done in times, why you have been not successful or why you have been successful, everything is written there. Now, I have underlined one thing only. This is Wikipedia. It says, he was biblical, he was a teacher of Bible, he was very religious, blah, 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 blah. But I have highlighted only one thing. That is, he was a 33rd degree Freemason of Scottish Rite Order. Anyone knows what is it? Anyone is aware of what it is? 33rd degree Freemasonry? No one expected. 33rd degree Freemason, well, Masonry is a society. Masonry is a society, is a secret society. Very secret society, predominantly originating from UK. Have roots everywhere, have roots even in Bombay and Calcutta. They give membership only to people who prove to them that they possess some special knowledge. It is a secret society. Even if you read about it, you will understand that even civilians or even general people who are not Freemasons are not even allowed in the lane in which their lodge is. They call it a lodge, where they hold their meetings. Where their lodge is placed, they don't even allow normal people to enter the lane. It is so secret, so secretive. And the degrees start. Now, this is important. 33rd degree is the highest degree. 33rd degree is the highest degree which is conferred to a Freemason. The entry degree is 8th. And it goes up to 33rd. Again, I'm trying to prove a point. I will come to that point. 33rd degree Freemasonry. Freemasons, it's said that it's a secret club of great people. But actually, it's a club of great people with secrets. It's a club of great people with secrets. Now, these are 33rd degree Freemasons. You will have to understand what is the pedigree. Who were conferred 33rd degree Freemasonry? Isaac Newton, Albert Einstein, Thomas Alva Edison, Antonio Meucci, Benjamin Franklin Benjamin. These were the people who were conferred 33rd degree Freemasons, Masonry. So, and W.D. Gann was a 33rd degree Mason. Point I want to prove is, now you please understand what was his mindset, what was the supernatural power he was having, what, how big, how great mathematician he was to have been conferred the 33rd degree Freemason. So you, everyone tries to learn Gann and says, it is difficult, it is not good, it does not apply, because angur khatte hai, nahi samajh mein aaya, bekar hai. But you will have to understand that why it is difficult. And it is not possible for me, for even me, anyone, probably I say, to understand and expertise, to be an expert in Gann in one lifetime. Because it is something like you try to master theory of relativity by Newton, something like that. So I don't think it is possible for a general trader or a human being to reach that frequency vibration. So first of all, be prepared that W.D. Gann is that complicated. It is not that it has just written, given, okay, do this. With due respect to you, Gann fan, Gann angle, these are all marketing tools. These are all marketing tools. It is a very old saying, anything sells in the name of Gann. And it is very, very common. Why? Because Gann is an occult science. There is nothing clearly written on Gann. Gann has written 8 books, but he has also not shared his secret. Why? He believed in natural laws. He said there is a universal law of compensation. I cannot give it or you cannot take it until you compensate for it. It's well written. He died making a statement, quote unquote, I'm dying without sharing the knowledge, sharing the secret, because the world is not ready for it. And the money so made can land in wrong hands and can lead to world destruction, unquote. So that was the mindset, that was the ability of that person, that he knew that this kind of thing cannot be given to the world. Otherwise, every other person will be a billionaire, and obviously everyone knows that everyone is not right. So money can be misused, and he wrote it can lead to world destruction. He died post World War II. If probably he would have shared the secret, we could have been had World War 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Any which ways, he was a scientist. He was a mathematician. He had this deep study of cycles, numerous cycles. In this process, obviously, when he mastered this art of cycles, he could easily predict forthcoming events. I just highlighted 2-3 main events which are his famous predictions. He predicted end of World War in the summer of 1918, 1 year in advance, it happened. He wrote a book, Tunnel Through the Air. I think every Gann knower must have heard about this book, Tunnel Through the Air. Anyone? Heard of it. And everyone tries to read it, the first book, because Gann padna hai, Tunnel Through the Air padho. But that is the most mystic book. Gann has written everything in that book. But you will have to elevate to the level of the frequency in which you can match what is written. Why Gann has not disclosed everything? Because he said the world is not ready. The world is not ready, what does that mean? He has talked extensively about the natural law of harmony. What is that harmony? The frequency. It should be harmonious. If I am saying something, you will be able to receive it only if our frequency is harmonious. It's normal telephony. Telephone ka frequency catch karta hai, we hear the voice. Frequency goes, we say it's not coming. Now, in the Tunnel Through the Air, the book was written in October. He signed the book. The book was written in 1927. But he signed the book giving a date of October 1940. and the book got published in 1928. What does that mean? What does that mean? Anyone? A book written in 1927, signed, autographed, published in 1928, but the date which he, the date which he has put as a signing is 1940. Anyone? Yeah, please. Very close. Basically, when he concluded the book, he signed putting a date of October 1940. As if he was living in 1940. And he predicted entire 13 years event in that. Sitting in 1927, writing it in 1927, getting it published in 1928, signing it in 1940, he predicted entire 13 years day by day in that. And in that book, on the date, there is a he's talking to himself and says that on a date, he put up date and 3rd October 1931, the stock market is in panic and the authorities are thinking of closing it. When wrote in 1927, published in 1928, he dated that page as 3rd October 1931. 5 years hence, actually on that day, New York Stock Exchange was kept closed for 3 days. Literally, they didn't close it, but they banned short selling, and Dow futures, Dow Jones and everything fell probably 23%. That was the pedigree. In the same book, he wrote, dating 1939, that hell has broke loose from air. Dating 1939, and the same day Hiroshima attacked. How? Through the air. Tunnel through the air. The book names Tunnel Through the Air. He predicted the start of World War II 12 years in advance. Exact date. Well, he has predicted n number of stock market things. By the day he has predicted, but he made his money. He predicted the best stock market crash of 1929, 1937, and bull runs of 1919 and 1932, where everywhere he made huge fortunes. Now, WD as a trader, I will just put 3 points as a trader. William E. Gillies was an inspector of imports, and he was a, you can say, a big gentleman, famous gentleman, covering interviews, and his words were enough. He asked Gann to trade in front of him. They, in fact, did some trades in partnership, and he writes in his writings about W.D. Gann that he has seen W.D. Gann making $12,000 from $130 in less than a month. Some authority is writing. It's not that anyone is claiming, some authority is writing it, because these were traded in front and in partnership with him. Now, this is September 1909 contract. Here again, I will try to prove a point, which is a major point. Another third one I cover, post-September, this 1909, I'm coming back to September 1909. Post-September 1909, after this famous prediction, you know, entire media was definitely behind him, but the authorities were also behind him then. The Securities Exchange Control, SEC, prevalent that time, asked all his trades to be monitored. They thought that he is, as everyone says, the stock market operator. He is actually creating prices. So, Richard D. Wyckoff, kitne log naam sune hai? How many of you have heard? Everyone probably. Wyckoff is very famous these days with Wyckoff Trading. Brijesh, good friend of mine, is teaching Wyckoff. This same gentleman, at that, with due respect to him and to everyone, he was not a technical analyst. This Wyckoff, famous gentleman, he was publishing Ticker magazine that time. He was not a technical analyst. He was covering person like W.D. Gann. I will not extend what I mean. Now, the SEC appointed Richard D. Wyckoff to monitor W.D. Gann's trade for a month. And the inspection was so strong that Wyckoff and Gann will have to live together. It is not that, okay, morning mein milte hain, shaam ko trade kiya chala gaya. They lived 30 days together. So sleep, drink, everything together. Gann did 286 trades in front of him, at times 16 trades a day, catching all tops and bottoms of the trade. Out of this, 264 trades were profitable, and he basically grew his capital 10 times. From $1,000, he ended with $10,000. Same month in front of Richard D. Wyckoff, which was very, very, very well, it was covered in the New York Times and everywhere. So now September 1909, where I would like to prove a point. What happened in September 1909? This guy, a gentleman called W.D. Gann, predicted that wheat contract of September 1909 expiring 30th September, will close at $1.20. Exact date, exact time, exact price. Great. Entire media, since, because he was, by that time, he was very famous, he was already a millionaire, everyone was covering him. Around 12 noon, the same day, 30th September, the day when the wheat contract was supposed to expire, at noon, it was trading at $1.08. $1.08. That means good 10 to 11% away from where the prediction was. And it's a wheat contract, mind it. So it is nothing which can be manipulated or something can happen to give a sudden spike of 11%. He was interviewed by New York Times and ticker and everyone. In fact, Wall Street Journal, it was the front page news. Wall Street Journal covered this particular thing, and they were actually tracking the entire month how the prediction was going. And then the same day it was interviewed that, sir, it's 12 noon and you have predicted $1.20. So now what next? See the authority of the person. See the authority of the person. Just read once in italics what he says. He says, I don't know what it is trading now. I am least bothered about what it is trading now. If it does not touch $1.20 by the close of the market, it will prove that there is something wrong with my whole method of calculation. That means a person is challenging himself. He is putting everything at stake. He is putting everything at stake and saying that my calculation will completely be challenged and it will be wrong if it does not close at $1.20. To everyone's surprise, last 15 minutes it gave a spike from 1.08 to 1.20. That was the highest price traded, and it closed actually at $1.20. Point I want to prove, friends, he was a scientist. Pedigree of a scientist. You know, these kind of statesmen, when you can make, and there is only one stream where you have only one answer. You know what? Anyone? Rest, everything is logic. There is only one stream, which is mathematics. In mathematics, you get only one answer. Correct? In any stream of mathematics, we have all studied from trigonometry, geometry, algebra, anything. In mathematics, it's always zero, equal to. I always say this. This gentleman had the LHS. You know what is LHS? Bachpan mein sab padhe hain. Left hand side. He knew the left hand side. And that is why he could equate it, solve it, and he knew what is the right hand side. Hence proved. If he did not know what is the left hand side, and he could not prove and solve the issue, solve the thing, solve the equation, something like running into numerous pages or whatever, something like theory of relativity, how could he said that my calculation says on 30th September, this will close at 1.20, not 1.19, not 1.21, but 1.20, and it actually happened. So this gentleman had the LHS of markets, of any instrument, any asset class. From there, he used to calculate the RHS. So LHS is equal to RHS, hence proved. Correct? Any questions? It's mystic. I know everyone will be mystic, mystified. That this is mystic. Yes, this is fact. Go and read it. Go and read it. Study. Study. Then you will understand what actually we are trying to learn. So it is not something Sharad Jhunjhunwala kyun, Sharad Jhunjhunwala forefathers will come and teach you. No. It's not possible. I also know probably less than 1%. But yes, in mathematics, as we all know, probably the best of some theory of relativity. Okay, that is also equations. But at least 2-3 equations we also know. A plus B square is equal to A square plus B square plus 2AB. So in the entire, when we were given papers, so entire paper mathematics, we have been taught that, okay, you don't understand everything, at least 2-3 equal to or hence, 2-3 lines if you can solve, at least that means you know something. So I am also trying to do the same thing, that I don't know the entire GAN formula, but at least 2-3 lines if I am able to decode, I think that is enough for my lifetime. It will be my achievement. I don't even think of achieving or solving this LHS and then coming to RHS. Correct? So that is the only reason I say GAN is a religion. It is a path. If you, and everyone knows, every religion is difficult. If you follow it properly, every religion is difficult. Every religion, you will try to be a baghi. No, this is not possible. This is not good. This is not easy. GAN is a religion. It is a path. If you want to actually follow, you will have to leave everything and actually follow as a religion, which probably is not possible for everyone, neither for me. But for the last 14 years, I've been trying to decode. First eight years were garbage in, garbage out, learning, unlearning, learning, unlearning. Then probably God strike right. Last 2-4 years, probably some I am in harmony with, probably a little bit of GAN's philosophy or equations or things are coming to me. Because that is how it works. If I want to say, it is like I can give you a fruiting tree. I give you a fruiting tree. But if I don't teach you how to sow that, what will happen? The tree will die. The tree will die. It will not give any more fruits. The same thing I say, that if I tell, many people ask me, okay, so now tell me where exactly we are in 2018. What is going to happen? Again, I have a thing to say. I can give you a matured fruiting tree, but I don't teach you how to sow. What will happen? You will get the fruits for one season. Then the tree will die. So if you ask me what is today, probably I will tell you. But what I want to show you as a path, how you can go forward in this GAN, in your quest to achieve a little bit of GAN. So the next part of my entire presentation, I end here. Now I will just try to lay the foundation. I will try to decode. I will try to say what are the foundations, what are the basics of WDGAN on which the entire WDGAN is built. Foundation pillars. What are the foundation principles? So come on. That I will tell. 2-3 things I will cover, because again these are related to what I will be talking henceforth. This is from W.D. GAN's book, the same book, Tunnel Through the Air, Truth of the Stock Tape. Habits of stock. How many do you believe that every stock has a habit? Every stock has a habit. There is a signature move. Let's see, if you can catch that signature move, then you can tell what is going to happen. Only 3 of you. So many traders trading day and night, but you don't understand that every stock has a habit. This habit, why I'm covering it here? When we go to square of 9, when we go to other things, this is one thing which I want to clear it to you, so that in case you go and try to pursue or read more about GAN, you will always keep in mind that Sharad ji has said, Habits of stock is important, and how to read habits of stock. Because the moment you understand what a stock is doing, a person who drinks every day, anyone wants to find him, knows post 7 p.m., he will be in a bar. If a person goes to Mandir, he's religious, he goes to Mandir every day, you want to find him, you know that morning, this time to this time, he's in a Mandir. Why not for a stock? You want to know where it will be tomorrow, day after, 1 year. You will have to first understand the habit of the stock, what the stock is trying to do. For a normal human being, when we try to portray, to project, predict, what is this person doing? We first understand that person. We try to know the habits. What a person does. We trade in stocks, we are trying to predict, we are trying to do everything about the stock, but we don't know the habit of stock. How is it possible? So this is, and he writes this very clearly. This is again written in a mystical form. If you want to decode it, the stock market is driven by human energy. Prices are made through buying and selling of human beings. And as human beings have certain habits, certainly the market of involved, blah, 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 blah. This is caused, as explained elsewhere, by a certain group of men pool that operate in a stock for a long, long time. In 1923, his book, This Truth of the Stock Tape, writes extensively about stock operators. Don't think that the stock market operation, Ketan Pareks of the world, are born today. 1923, this guy writes extensively about how stock market operators work. Extensively about. I'm telling you, anything which you have come across in trading is already covered in this book and talked extensively. The mystic form behind this is, how many of you believe in astrology? Let us come to the point. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, that's it. How many of you amongst them believe that stock prices can be manipulated, and stock prices have any effect from astrology? Astrology. Astrology affects stock market prices. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Wow, great. This is because of astrology. I am telling you why that is the reason I have kept this slide. How? The buying and selling is induced by human behavior. What induces human behavior? Planetary positions, everyone knows probably. I don't know, due respect to people who don't believe in astrology, but we all at times have gone to our astrologers or consulted what is happening, what will happen, what has happened. And they tell us this is good, this is bad, this is ugly, do this, do that. That means these planetary positions, when a simple move of moon can attract the entire water of oceans, simple move of moon, that's the smallest planet, can attract the entire waters of an ocean. Why do we disbelieve that planetary moves, including the major planets, will not influence human mind, human, which are again 70% water. We are talking about science. Science has said we are 70% water. So 70% water, a simple moon distorts oceans, then entire planetary moves. We disbelieve that it will not distort human mind. People come to me and say, no, sir, how is it possible? Something happening in planetary position, something happening in sky, how I will be affected? I can't argue. I can explain the rational, I can put it. So this is how the prices are formed as per GAN. Human behavior induced, and mind it, GAN has not written about astrology in his books till 1932. Post 1932, he wrote something about astrology in his books. See, try to understand that age. He was a Jew. He came to India, read Vedic astrology. But in US that time, it was kind of an occult science, Kala, Tantra, black magic. People will kill if he talks about astrology that time. And being a Freemason, being a Freemason, being a person of high stature, he cannot talk of a subject which will say, oh, you are an idiot. So in all his books, and this kind of this, he's written in mystical form. He's written in mystical form. And next slide I will show you, he's again more mystical. He's again more mystical. So why? Because he was not actually writing on astrology. But when you decode, you understand. When you decode, you understand what actually he was meaning. He was meaning this human behavior is getting affected by a certain planetary positions, and that is why the prices are formed. A majority of people are buying either, or a majority of people are selling, or it's equal. Few people are destined to lose, few people are destined to win. So people who are destined to lose are doing what market doesn't want. People who are destined to win are doing exactly what market wants. Very simple. Everyone knows. Gann has written very extensively about a topic. He says the best of traders should actually know when to trade. And above all, he should know when not to trade. And that is also, he was pointing about this. Because best of traders, I suppose, best of traders had bad and worst patches. If only they could avoid that bad or worst patch, they would have been elsewhere. Why? How? So this is, anything? Okay. But then I will be having less of slides and more of. So, where I was? Where was I? Bad patch. So these operators, anyone, any best of traders, everyone has a bad patch. And Gann actually wanted to say, and he has written in his books, he must understand that this is not the right time for them. And I have felt that I've been in market for the last 28 years, doing active trading. From a stock market family, my grandfather, both maternal and paternal are founding members of Calcutta Stock Exchange and Bombay Stock Exchange. So it is in the blood. This patch, we all know, and if we can only avoid this. So if you are having a streak of losing trades, I won't say that go and consult an astrologer, but at least kill that time. Avoid. Don't fight. You know, first 2-3 trades never kill you. The moment you start fighting it, then you are killed. First 2-3, 4-5 trades will never kill you. They are comfortable losses because you are mentally prepared for that kind of drawdowns. But the moment you start fighting, why do you fight? Again, that is your mindset. Your mindset. You are now influenced by some Rahu Ketu of the world. So, please don't misunderstand me that I am more into astrology. Astrology, I am zero in astrology, believe me. I am trying to learn astrology for the last few months only. A little here and there. I am just trying to take little bit grabs here and there. But since Gann has this foundation and this basis, and I am talking about Gann, I must tell this. That proper Gann cannot be done without astrology. Because the basis of entire predictions, entire movements, okay, prices, trading, I will give you a shortcut, enough, you can make good money. But if you want to pursue, I'm not saying that you need to be expert in Gann. I've just started learning Gann here and there astrology for last few months only. But okay, at least ups and downs, tops and bottoms, I've been calling for the last 4-5 years real time on Twitter. So that is different. Now coming back to next slide. Now how many of you believe that there are certain stocks which are your enemies? Whenever you trade, you lose. Anyone? Good. That's it. In my seminars, I find 60%, 70% people raising hand and saying, yes, for me Arcom, for me Reliance Capital, for me Dr. Reddy's, for me this, for me that. There are certain stocks which are your enemies. And he has written this in the same book, 1923. And he has tried to explain a very, very valid point. See, every stock has a frequency. Every stock has its natal belonging, natal charts, how it is destined. You have your own. It is not necessary that everything will match and yours will match with everything. I think many, many speakers, instructors, they come and say, don't try to play all the stocks. Try to play few stocks. Why? Well, they don't talk about astrology, they don't talk about GAN, but the fact remains, try to identify stocks which are profitable to you. GAN says them as friendly stocks. These are my friends. Because the moment, see, it's like a marriage. It's like a marriage. The best person to predict you is your spouse. She or he knows the exact thing you are going to do. Even when they are talking, when we talk to our spouse, while talking also we know what she is about to tell next or how she is about to react next. Correct? Why? Because we understand habit of stock, we know the habit, we have understood the entire thing, and the frequencies are matching. And the frequencies are matching. And that is why we say that these are harmonious marriages, successful marriages, these are disharmonious or unsuccessful marriages. So, okay, done. Why? Why? Because you need to identify which are the stocks, which are your enemies, which will, whatever be the trade, I have seen, recently, 3-4 days back only, I told a trade to, I was on a drinking session with my friends and I shared a trade. Okay, do this. Out of 3 people doing the trade, 2 people made good money, very good money. One person lost. I'm sharing the trade right now. Just before coming to Calcutta, Bombay, it was, today is Friday, Tuesday night probably, Wednesday, I asked my friends to short crude. It was trading at 49.10-49.15 or something like that. I asked them to short crude and hold it for a good 500 to 600 rupees fall, minimum. And I told stop loss, well, GAN has a phenomenon of stop loss, but it again depends on a natural law. Again, I'm referring to natural law. Natural law of vibration. If I have a stop loss of, say for example, 49.60, but it is not something which I put on screen. What is law of vibration? I need to see how it vibrates. It goes there and how it behaves. How it behaves there. There are 2 forces which work. One is at law of attraction, another is law of ripplement. So whether it is repelling or whether it is attracting, I need to see the behavior of the stock at that particular price. So I basically said, keep a 50-60 rupees stop loss. One guy who traded got stopped out and said, "Arey nahi sir," because again his mindset, he while sharing the trade only, he said that I am very bullish, you are crazy, this is going to happen, that is going to happen, it's like $130, Sambula, okay, $130, I agree, but we are sharing a trade today, tomorrow. We are not talking about something what is going to happen probably in 2019. But he had this matha, he had this in his brain, predetermined bias notion, he traded, he lost money. The other 2 guys traded, called me today, it is down 280 rupees from there. They called me, what to do? I said, hold. Book 50%, rest hold. Just with, it happened with me. I'm talking about last 72 hours. So what does that mean? The guy is not destined, basically he is not harmonious with crude. And these 2 guys, and I'm sure if I go back and ask any astrologer to check the Kundali, these guys will be friendly Saturn and that guy will be anti-Saturn. There will be, I'm just sharing very simple thing. There are 9 planets, out of which there are few planets which are malefic, few planets which are benefic. What are they? Basically, it is like godly and what is the other thing? Evil. Basically, evil and God. So see, this Saturn, Rahu, Ketu, and blah 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 blah. 3-4 planets. They are Budh. They are all malefic planets. They are anti-planets. And good planets are something like Moon, Sun, Jupiter. So 3-4 planets are. These will not. If I am, my horoscope says I am Jupiter strong. It is Jupiter based. And if someone else is Rahu based, I can give you in writing that we will not gel together. It has happened with everyone. How many people like meet any person, unknown person, just for the first time, and within 3 minutes they feel uncomfortable and they say, and they just walk out. Why? The vibrations don't match. The vibrations, that vibration, law of attraction, law of vibration, that law of vibration doesn't match. The frequency doesn't match. And go back to history. Go back to history in the sense, go back to what Gan mastered. Go back and you will find what is the reason. I will again come to this when I will be talking about natural laws, law of causation. That is the law of causation, is the law on which entire Gan is written. What is that law of causation? Anyone? No one. Law of causation, it's a universal law. It's a universal law which says nothing happens without a cause. Every cause has an effect. And Gan says if this is a natural law, universal law, if something is universal, that means it should apply to everything. And he challenged himself that if it applies to everything, then why not stock market? And that is the spark which he got. And he said, if everything has a, every effect has a cause, then if I know the cause, I will know the effect. And that is the reason he started finding causes. And he tried to decode this LHS is equal to RHS. What is LHS? LHS is the cause. Left hand side is the cause. It may happen today, it may have happened 100 years back. The effect is going to happen or probably has happened. That is the RHS. So this is law of causation. This is law of causation. So everything happens for a reason. It is law of causation. I have covered a lot of future things to be, but during the flow. Here, see how mystically he writes, when he writes about stocks which are your enemies, certain stocks which, whatever, they will always land you in losses. I could explain to you the cause for this, but it is not necessary, and many of you would not believe it. This book was written in 1923. As I said, he was not talking anything about astrology at that point of time. He didn't even tell the world that he even knows astrology. What is astrology? But he knew it. And he also wanted to write a book. And when someone wants to write, say, correctly, truthfully, then whatever it is in mind, it will come out of passion. Now I am speaking. It is my passion. I can go on speaking for days. It's coming. I don't need to think and then say. So when he's writing this book, it is coming to him that I should write when I am writing that stocks which are your enemy, and people will ask why. He wrote in one line, I could explain you the reason, but you will not believe it. And it is not necessary. So this is a takeaway in future. You can do a back test or in henceforth trades. If you find that there are certain stocks, certain things which are not profitable to you, which always lands you in losses. I have seen, I have traded n number of stocks. Probably I will trade it intraday with the best of setup and it goes up 7%, and I see, okay, now I am deep in the money, no problem, I will leave the position. Next day, invariably that will give you a 10% gap down. Invariably, and it has happened to me n number of times. So now I'm coming back to the three pillars of Gan. These are three things on which entire Gan is based. The entire Gan is based on, first is mathematics. For mathematics, he was a if we'd follow our Pythagoras, he has mentioned Pythagoras a number of times. Anyone? Any question? Oh. He has quoted Pythagoras n number of times. As Pythagoras said, mathematics existed before God, quote unquote. Pythagoras wrote, mathematics existed before God. God created, matlab, mathematics, God created and another, this gentleman, unfortunately forgetting the name, he wrote, God created mathematics first, then he created the planet. Because, you know, why we are talking about this? This entire universe is mathematics, no? Exact, calculated from time, date, hours, months, years, seconds, Earth takes for a rotation. Every planet takes for a rotation. Is it not mathematics? Earth shape, circle, mathematics. They have an orbit, eclipse. Everything moves as they are programmed to move. And everyone knows there is no programming without mathematics. Try to understand what I'm trying to say. That the entire existence is based on mathematics. Entire existence is based on mathematics. The existence, the creation of planets, the creation of humankind, everything is based on mathematics. I will not go deep into this because then it will continue. He has been graceful by giving me some extra time. Second pillar is natural laws. As I have told, shared, we will come to that slide. I have already mentioned most of the natural laws which are the basis of WDGAN. Third is time cycles. Now, this time cycles, you can refer as astro, you can refer as anything. There are n number of time cycles. Everything is timed from the smallest move to the biggest move. Everything is moving in a sync, in a harmony. Sab cheez ka ek chaal hai, jaisa ek, we have the sound waves, you know, in bachpan we have this sound waves going up and down in a frequency. So everything is running on a predetermined particular frequency. And the moment the frequency changes, we know we are having earthquakes and something like that. So disasters. And what happens? Immediately after the disaster, again it becomes harmonious. Basically, the moment it goes inharmonious, these disasters happen. And immediately post that, things become harmonious. Everything, the frequency again comes. Suddenly we lose a signal, awaaz nahi aa raha. And then again suddenly it starts. Why? Because frequency starts matching. Your device starts catching the frequency. So if the device can start catching the frequency, why not human being? Why I am saying all these, why I am wasting your time explaining this, because as I said in the beginning only, GAN is only GAN. I can't give you a ready-made this minus this, do this tomorrow and it will happen. But I will give, don't worry. So this is time cycle I will cover, probably if time permits I will try to cover in deeper details. Mathematics. Now, mathematics is something which is vast, something which is very complicated, it's very complex. But what Gyan Baba did, he made this square of 9. How many of you have seen this square of 9 before? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 6, 7, 8. Anyone amongst you, are you aware how to use this? Yes, I know. I will not ask a question to you. Anyone? How to use square of 9? Anyone? No. You know? Please share your views. Please share your views. Mike, please. Anyone?
In the square of 9 on the center, you write any earlier top or bottom, and then it takes the numbers, and then you can see all these cross lines, they become the important point. Similarly, you can have a date, the square of 9 for the dates, and they become the important dates, you know, for any happening in the future.
We do, with due respect to the you, that is bullshit. That is bullshit. It is correct. It was discussed by Gann. It is shared by Gann. But the I just simply get a bad word. I get pissed off when I come across people who are trying to use shortcuts. These are shortcuts. Bachpan se sikhaya gaya, there is no shortcut to success. And we are trying to have a shortcut for a science, for a religion, for a path. You are right to some extent, that is, we call dynamic square of 9. But that is not how it is used, my dear friend. That is not how it is used. Now, this is the original square of 9. I have taken a picture from his book, and I have tried to show you how it looks like. Basically, he tried to say that in mathematics, we have only two directions, up or down. And stock market also, we have only two directions, up or down. We either like in mathematics, we have addition, subtraction. What is the other thing? Anyone? Other than subtraction and addition? Multiplication and division. But what is that? Multiplication is just a faster way of addition, and division is a faster way of subtraction. So there are actually only two directions, up and down. This Gyan Baba, when he challenged himself that when natural laws exist, and when he read Pythagoras, and Pythagoras writes that everything follows mathematics. Our mobile, telephony, math, anything, even Wright brothers, when they were creating aeroplane, that time it was widely covered. It is all about mathematics. Wind energy, this, that. And he challenged to himself, when mathematics is the base, and mathematics can only give you one answer, rest everything is logic, then why mathematics cannot be applied to stock markets to get that one answer? And that is why he did whatever research he wanted to do. He went to Greece, he came to India, he locked himself for 3 months in London Museum, just studying data for cotton for last 1,000 years. And he, in his writing, he have said, I can predict for what is going to happen 1,000 years down the line. But for that, I need that much of data. But anyway, that we will discuss in time cycle. This is square of 9. There are dates, and he talked about three. In mathematics, there are two directions, and there are three shapes. There are three shapes. What are they? Anyone? Huh? Exactly. So there is square. Anything else is a derivation of this, be it eclipse, be it rectangle, whatever, it is a derivation of this. So there are only three shapes. All the three shapes have been used here. It's a square of 9. It looks like a pyramid if you say it properly. Giza pyramid from top will look like this. How many of you have Shri Yantra at home? No one, only one. Sir, sab kuch aap hi. Does it not look like this if you look from top? I'm a staunch believer that whatever exists in any other country or whatever, I'm very proud to be an Indian, and I staunchly believe that everything has been taken from India. There is nothing before our Upanishads and Veda existed. And the Shri Yantra is in Upanishad. And I can prove it to any level, any extent I can prove it. I can challenge anyone. So this is How square of 9? Basically, the one is in between and it goes in a spiral. Circle, square of 9, it's called square of 9. There are dates, there are certain dates which are mentioned. Those are equinox dates. Those are solstice and equinox dates on the cardinal cross. I will come to cardinal cross. And again, divided by 4. So basically, every month is having a date, which are permanent Gyan dates. These dates are important, but if you want to filter it, please check every year equinox date shifts by 1 or 2 days. So if you actually want to see the effect, see that if you are looking at for 2016, when actually the first equinox March is placed, it comes in, even the Google search gives you today, this year's equinox, which day. So if it is 21st March and this year's equinox is on 23rd March, at least postpone all days by 2 days to have a better expression. Now, this is square of 9, which I use. Now, because that was not legible, let us come to this. Can everyone see this? The numbers? No? See, 1 is here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. This goes like this, clockwise. Okay? This number, this blue line, is called cardinal cross. You know anyone, what is the meaning of cardinal cross? Anyone? No one. Jesus, the cross on which Jesus is hanged or whatever. Yeah. So that is called a cross, cardinal cross. That is called a cardinal cross. So basically, you can say this. Basically, you can also say this is kind of a death cross. This is kind of a death cross. Okay? Now, what is this? This is called diagonal cross. This is called diagonal cross. Now, I'm unable to question you because it is not probably legible to most of you. Otherwise, I could have asked any observation on this. Anyone having any particular observation on this? Huh? No. I'm not. Nothing. This color, blue and red, is put by Sharad Jhunjhunwala. So you can put any color. Gan 1 was like this. So no flag exists here. See, without killing time, it is made in such a beautiful fashion. You see, this is 4. This is 16. This is 36. This is 64. This is 100. This is 144. This is 196. Anything you observe? Square of even numbers. All the square of even numbers right from 4 are placed in this diagonal line. All numbers. So basically the Pythagoras table, which is a square is equal to b square plus c square, that has been made in a pictorial format. Okay? See, 16, 36, 64, 100, 144. See, this is. Now, come here. What is this? 9, 25, 49, 81, 121. What are these? Great. So, see how beautifully just a spiral starting from 1 and all the numbers come in sync. All the numbers. जैसे बोलते हैं ताश के पत्ते सब एक संग बिछ गए. सो दिस इज ऑल द नंबर्स आर कमिंग इन सिंक विथ ऑल द स्क्वायर ऑफ ऑड नंबर्स कमिंग हियर, ऑल द स्क्वायर ऑफ इवन नंबर्स कमिंग हियर, एंड वन सर्कल इफ यू से कंप्लीट्स फ्रॉम वन स्क्वायर टू अनदर स्क्वायर. एग्रीड? इफ वी प्रिज्यूम दैट द सर्कल स्टार्ट फ्रॉम हियर 81, then where will the circle end? It will go like this. It will come and end 121. So this is 9 square. This is 11 square. So what is happening? We are in 360 degree rotation. We are covering 2. Should I repeat this? Should I repeat this? When we are starting a circle, 360 degree rotation, 360 degree rotation, which is the rotation we know that it completes a circle, 360 degree. So here, from here, if we want to rotate 360 degree, we want to complete a circle from 81. Obviously, it will end here. That is 360 degree, one rotation. Agreed? So if this is 9 is square, it is 11 square. Half circle is what? Anyone? 180 degree. And what it is? We started from 9 square. Exactly. See the a square plus b square is equal to c square, how beautiful it is placed. So we start from 9 square, we move 180 degree, we come at 10 square, half circle. We complete another 180 degree, we come to 11 square. So my dear friend, you are talking. So if you place any number, this combination will not be there. You place any number in between, for a 11,000 numbered Nifty, if you place 11,000 and you said all the cross will be resistance and all the cross will be support, so the starting point will be 11,002 will is resistance, 11,007 is also a resistance, 11,009 is also a resistance, 11,013 is also a resistance. That is a way, but how to use it is different. So this is how it works. This is what square of 9 is. How it squares and how it rotates. Now, we want to use it. I don't think we have time, but still, the important thing is, as I said, this is death cross. These are important numbers, especially this line. What are this line? This line is called natural squares. Natural, we have been learning from class probably 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, whatever. These are natural squares, 1 square, 2 square, 3 square, 4 square, 5 square. Go and do your homework once you receive this presentation, or you can download from anywhere. You will be astonished to find these are 9.5 square. If we start from 9 and this is 10 square, this is 9.5 square. Again 90 degree, this is 10.5 square. And this is again, it will come to 11. So there are mathematical ways also to derive what is the next cardinal number or next diagonal number for a particular instrument. And that is by taking a square root, adding 0.5 or 1, and then again doing a root to it. So obviously that half rotation, you will understand what is the half rotation, quarter rotation. As simple as that. As simple as that. So the importance of this is death cross, this is number to be followed, these are of importance but minor. These are like what, you know, subwaves type, intermediate tops and bottoms. I have seldom in my study see these making major tops other than Nifty. Nifty has an odd behavior where it behaves here. But anyway, so we are coming to next slide. Anyone having any question, a square of 9, because this is the basis. This is the basis. Yeah, please. No, I'm asking you to now move forward.
If it's a spiral.
It's a spiral, no? If you visualize it like
not circle.
This. If you visualize this like it's a spiral, it is numbers are going, moving ahead and ahead.
Yeah. So
at this point, see, at this point, exactly at this point, your circle and your spiral breaks, because here it is 160. Everywhere you will find, here you will not find the upper number in sync. 160 ke upar hai aapka 249 or something like that. Why? Because this is the place where it moves one step forward and then again starts counting.
So at some it place, it is changing the radius. That's what I mean. As long as you say circle, that's all.
Yeah,
no other objection.
Spiral. It's a spiral.
Thank you.
Obviously, if it is circle, how can we continue?
Precisely.
It will end. No, we it write three end, numbers
then,
and it will
then,
end.
There and there is spiral.
We'll yeah. write three numbers and then it ends. This is the place where it breaks. This is the line where this breaks.
Yes.
This is 119, 120, 121, 122, 123. Correct?
Correct.
121, 122, 123. For this number, this is not in sync.
No.
For this number, this is not in sync because uske upar 122 aaya hai. Aapko to yahan pe har number uske sang match kar raha hai when this is 121, 122, 123. Sure. But for this number, it is not in sync. This is 169. This is the place where this harmony is broken. And these are important numbers, very important numbers.
Okay.
For major cycles, probably these are the numbers where it breaks.
And okay, this is done. And please tell us again about these two lines. One was square and the other was, you said,
this is a line of obviously resistance and support, but kind of intermediate. I have not found much of major tops and bottoms being formed here other than Nifty. So this is one line which gives intermediate kind of a top. Waves mein bolte hai na ki ek top hua, it is respected. Don't give less now credit to it. But these are always respected. But nothing to be off. It will respect probably, the price will move till here, come back 180 degree rotation or maybe go back 360 degree rotation. And again, eventually cross it. How this, what is, this is how it moves, no? Stop, it will start moving here, 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 here. Suppose it now resists this, what will happen? It will again go rotation, back rotation. Even the planets go back, you know. There is a retrograde move.
Reference-wise.
Retrograde move, yeah, reference-wise. Anyone, any more question? Yeah, please. Same. Cardinal cross, basically cardinal cross. So, death cross. These are of important resistance and supports. Very important. See, these are the numbers. Basically, these are natural numbers. If you are calculating anything from natural numbers, these two lines, cardinal cross and diagonal cross, these are, matlab, aap simple koi cheez kar rahe ho, ek square of nine leke baith jao, initially, 2 months, 6 months, or kuch bhi mat karo, to aap dekhoge ki stock kaise behave kar raha hai is numbers ke aaspaas. And you will see the fun. You will see the fun. Though time does not permit me to explain actually how the habit works and how actually this square of nine, because sare stocks ka to low and bottom isi number pe nahi hota hai na. So there is a habit, and that habit is to be read from this square of nine, interfaced, and taken forward, yeah. No, I have seen Nifty making good tops and bottoms on this line. But other than Nifty, major tops and bottoms I have not seen on this line. I am sharing my experience. See, I am just giving you one example because I was said the time is short. I have explaining more because DJ came and just whispered that, okay, you can take 1 hour more. So that is why, but still he said 8 o'clock and we are close to 8 o'clock. I'm sharing a very simple chart of DLF. Very, very simple chart of DLF. This is one chart, probably in our raw language we say, iski chaal bahut achhi hai, bachalan nahi hai. Ekdam bhi bachalan nahi hai. It actually moves perfectly with natural numbers. Absolutely with natural numbers. And there are n number of stocks, you will have to find it. You will have to find the habit. And how I have found the habit of DLF? What was the first thing you do when you try to find read a stock from the GAN point of view, the habit? I found these two tops were exactly 169. Some paisa, ignore it, because those are vibrations. Our markets are also not that mature that exact it will go till that tick and it will reverse. this low was 72.35. Exactly. And this was 81. This was 81. Something striked me. I started trading this. Now, these blue and green lines, all the red lines, this red figures are natural squares. This is 81, this is 100, this is 121, this is what, comes 144, 116, natural numbers, means odd, even, whatever, square, 1, 2, 3, 4, starts from 9 square, 9 square, 10 square, 11 square, 3rd, and these are 0.5. So, basic, simple calculator, if this is 100 square, 10.5 into 10.5 is 110.25. Simple calculator, these lines are drawn. This is updated till probably day before, because yesterday I could not, even the spike which came 2 days back is exactly till this, exactly this level was 192.25 and the low was probably 192.40. It didn't close below the next natural number, which was 190 something, I don't know, I don't remember. So, 196, sorry, 196, 14 square, 196, 220, 272, 225 behavior is superb, that is 15 square. This is how you trade. This is habit of stock. Why I covered that only one slider, habit of stock. You, to understand which stocks, now this same habit will not apply to every stock. Every stock never makes a top of 100 rupees or 225 rupees. That particular stock probably will have a different habit. This particular stock has a habit of following natural numbers. And see, I have been presenting this DLF chart since my first seminar in January of 2017, where it was, I think, somewhere here, 2017, when I first shared this chart, it was here. I have just kept it updating in all my seminars, and before coming here also, I just kept it updating, and it is just picture perfect. It is picture perfect. I started sharing, if someone is, Murtaza was my first seminar attendee in Calcutta. So, anyone Calcutta attendee, you ask, they still have this old chart of DLF from my first seminar to, this is my 7th public appearance. I have been just continuously just sharing this DLF chart, and it is behaving perfectly. It's a perfect child. Behaves exactly how it is supposed to behave. All the numbers are preset. So, basically now what, how to take a trade? If someone asks me how to take a trade, you know these numbers, you have understood the habit of this stock, natural numbers, you draw these lines, see the behavior, and probably any trader with 6 to 8 months or 1 year of experience can easily trade if these lines I give. And you know that, okay, this is the top, it has, okay, give comfort, wait for confirmation, no problem. I trade exactly at the tip, at the bottom, at the, with 1 rupee stop loss. But that is with experience. You can even trade when it shows first closing reversal, second closing reversal, and you know that, okay, it reversed exactly from where it was supposed to. So, even if at this 272 exactly you don't sell, you can sell somewhere here when it completes 90 degree rotation. So that if it completes 90 degree rotation, your stop loss goes, I know it is deep, 14 rupees, I will never take this trade. I don't take trade for more than 0.25% stop loss. But first confirmation probably, first negative close, 268, 266, whatever. And you just need to wait for some price action around 272. Because now you know that this is there, this is there. This is there, this is there. This is a homework, you can all go, just see. This is how square of 9 works. Gyan Baba has converted that mathematics Obviously, there are deeper mathematics also. But this is simplest, and that is why he shared this in public domain. Simplest way where he said, find the habit and trade. These are natural numbers. They will always, because natural numbers means they have something to do with nature, and they will definitely show their effect. Even in normal stocks, they show their effect. But obviously, I will not say that peaks and lows are made there. But for example, DLF, it is picture perfect. I will just share how to take another, say, investment kind of trade or longer time frame trades. Yeah. Anyone? Yeah, please. Please. How will it repeat? How? No, my dear friend, if you put 100, let me clear. This starts from 1. Okay? You are saying that I start putting 100 here.
No, not.
I put 100 here because 100 was the top.
Yeah.
So what will be this number 103? It will be 106. This number will be 111. This number will be 131, which has no relevance to this DLF. 131 has no relevance to DLF. Try to understand, my dear friend. This is a shortcut. Every 2 rupees is not a resistance to DLF.
No. The lines you have drawn, the red and the blue,
yes,
in the chart,
yes,
that is all the numbers which are appearing in the blue and red here.
In the original square of 9.
In the original square, right? So if you start from any one.
Which number? Tell me, I will.
Anyone in the chart.
Huh?
Anyone in the chart.
You name it.
The lowest which
81.
Is. Yeah, 81.
Okay. I put 81 here, then?
Yeah, 82, 83, 84.
So, 83 becomes a resistance, 86 becomes a resistance, 87 becomes a resistance, 89 becomes a resistance. So, every other number becomes a resistance. Where in my chart, from 81 to 90.25 and 100, it's clean.
No, then, this DLF has the pricing, which are within say 300-400.
Well, see, this is going into an argument. I will not. This is dynamic. I am saying that it was discussed by Gann. That is dynamic square of 9, but that usage is different. The usage is different. I would not suggest, even for Nifty. I am telling you, my dear friend, if you want, I don't use any softwares. I don't use anything. I still, whatever GAN calculations I do on a printed graph paper. Now, if you say how I find a graph paper, obviously I take help of technology. Till 30,000, I have made 1x1 squares, got it printed on a A0 sheet, that is 2.5 feet. By 2.5 feet, it is something like this big.
Now one question. Yeah. Even up to 30,000, you started with zero.
Yes.
Okay, done. Thank you.
Yes, because that is the only way. There is no shortcut. Definitely, I will share. We will carry it offline. I will share with you my chart, hand drawn chart also. Trading, you are saying something which is a 1 year, 2 year, 3 year time frame. I told you, I never defied it. I said the usage is different.
You also like to have
Actually, I never carry this because that is even that is precious than anything else to me. I just carry it for a friend of mine. She will be coming and I will be explaining something to her. So this is just beginner's way I'm sharing. Check for price action when stocks makes major low or high around these numbers, these natural numbers, or diagonal cross, cardinal cross, if you can see, if you can see, like if you can give that much time or whatever. Otherwise, simply these natural squares, this list is endless. This list is endless. I had less of time. This is my first ever presentation I have made. That too, before coming here 3 days back, I asked my 12-year-old son to teach me what is PowerPoint and how to make a presentation. So he taught me 3-4 things, so I just could whatever I could put. So I have not put much. See the example of all-time high reversals on natural numbers. Godrej, PVR, I have taken only F&O stocks. Godrej, PVR, Amar Raja, Union Bank, Maruti, Axis Bank, CAPF. List is endless for bottoms also and tops also. Now you will say that all the stocks are not behaving like this. Okay, I only know this much. And I think if I can master only this much and I can trade this much, I'm not supposed to trade everything. These are the stocks probably. If I would have shorted anything from this, probably other than one Godrej CP or something, which has just recently 3 days back made a top. Otherwise, everything is down minimum 20% to 40%. Yeah, please. What you have to do. First of all, this session, don't expect, and I would not expect you to trade from tomorrow based on what Sharad Jhunjhunwala idiot told you. Spend some time studying the behavior of that stock, anything which you track, with a simple square of 9, and see the behavior. What I am trying to say is, certain stocks behave perfectly on the cardinal and diagonal cross. Moment you find one, 2, 3, 4, that means you have found the habit of that stock. Means at least that girl has said you hi. At least that girl has said you hi. Now you can start dreaming of dating and then going ahead. So at least make proposals and ask, let her say hi. So the moment you find 2, 3, 4 stocks where you are actually getting the vibes start matching. In GAN language, the vibes start matching and you start understanding the habit, then you can take the discussion and take the relation forward. So first understand, give some time. So give some time on this simple natural cross, because we cannot go in much deeper details. So this is the simplest thing I am telling you of natural square, cardinal cross and diagonal cross. Aap usi pe numbers pe aap stocks ko agar find kar rahe ho, and you start finding trades, numbers or stocks which probably made us high or a bottom at one of these numbers, and wait for next one or two moves and see whether it is actually behaving how it's supposed to behave. Give time, read, and I assure you next all moves you will be able to trade with minuscule stop loss. Why GAN used to trade so many, he used to take so many trades. The stop losses were very, very small. If you read GAN, you will understand that he used to give trades of an option of 30 rupees or 20 rupees. That days, the trading was in anas, what we call anas. So he used to give a stop loss even to the extent of 132, 1 by 32, means half an ana, or 1 by 16. Like, I think he has never thought of giving in 200 point, 400 points stop loss. 200 points means 200 ticks. I'm calling because this was the tick for price, shares price less than $30, they used to tick in 132. And above $30, they used to tick in 116th at that time. So I don't think that he ever traded for more than stop loss with more than 4 to 5 ticks or 7 ticks. Anyone on this? Basically natural numbers. So basically this mathematics portion I will complete. I will go to the next portion. We have got two more portions to complete. Natural law and time cycle. So just for your catch up, you don't need to trade every instrument unless you know the habit of that instrument. I have covered this. Limit your study and attention to selected few which are your friendly stocks. They will continue to be loyal to you and reciprocate the same feeling to you. You be loyal to that stock or instrument. I guarantee you that instrument will be loyal to you. It's just like a human relation. Try to make that stock your girlfriend. And better if you can make wife. Become harmonious to them and come to the same frequency at which they are. And you will be able to listen every vibe of them. That is a fact. I sincerely feel so. There are certain, not to boast of, but gold. I feel gold talks to me. Gold talks to me. So, I could not hear. My dear friend, please stand up and say. No, no, not you. Vivek. There were few people standing when we were having a dinner, drinks in fact. And in front of them, I shorted gold at 520 rupees. Stop loss was 25 rupees only. And Vivek, my dear friend, he said he's very bullish. I said, okay, I share your bullishness, but this is a trade for me and I think it will pay off. Yesterday, immediately before parting, it was down 50, 60 rupees only. Today, it gave me 300 rupees in 15 minutes. It was down 300 rupees today. It fell down 270 rupees in probably 15 minutes. So I came to Vivek. I said, Vivek, the trade is successful. I'm busy here. And I believe that whenever there is a windfall, take it. Because God will give you one opportunity. So if the windfall comes, I was not prepared for a 400 rupee profit in a gold in 12 hours. I got it. I took it. I feel blessed. Now I will see the next move. So become harmonious to them. Come to your same frequency at which they are and you will be able to listen every vibe of them. This is here I complete. Not natural laws. I have basically covered, the time is short, we have basically covered during our discussion, these are five important universal natural laws. See, whenever we talk about natural and universal laws, that means it should apply everywhere. It should apply everywhere. Even it should apply to the smallest particle of dust, which is beneath your foot. It will apply to the smallest particle of dust. If it is something to be called universal and natural, that means it should apply to everything that exists. Then why not stocks? Then why not any instrument? So, quick law of attraction. You must have heard anyone reading about GAN or something. Law of attraction. That is the price. And time, how time attracts price, how price attracts time, means a particular price, how a stock reaches a price at a particular time or spends more time at the same price. This is law of attraction. It's like, again, there are two parts of it. Law of attraction and law of, basically there are two kind of action at a particular level which the law of attraction says either it will repel. Repel means suddenly it's like magnet, you know, north and south, it will attract. If it is north and south, it will.
Central bank decisions.
Repel. That is what called repel. Fake dena. And that is how tops and bottoms are made. The price is not, the price at which it reaches is now no more harmonious. Jitna tak pahunchna tha pahunch gaya, now uske niche it is not harmonious. It looks very odd when I say this kind of a language, you, all traders with all mechanical systems, they will say it's all bloody bullshit. But this is how it works. If you want to hear GAN, this is how it works. So it becomes inharmonious at a certain level. And that is how, yeah, please.
Nifty started falling, before Nifty started falling, there was a Chandra Grahan.
Lunar was
January mein tha shayad wo, lunar eclipse. So sir, uska bhi koi relation hai kya? I mean, if you remember January mein, there was a lunar eclipse.
We are still on a train, you are trying to catch a flight. Wait, my dear friend.
Nahin, nahin sir, matlab...
Khatam nahin hua hai.
Okay.
We have not reached time cycle. That is a time cycle.
Okay, I'll wait for your call. Thank you so much.
They still don't know you after all these years?
Kya karein?